Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss lactulose. Lactulose is one of the disaccharide which is indicated for the treatment of chronic constipation. So in the patients with history of constipation for longer periods, this lactulose can be given in order to increase the bowel movements. So within the colon, lactulose can act so that it increases the movements of colon, but it takes some time as lactulose should reach to the colon. So this drug shows pharmacological effects after 24 to 48 hours. As within this time, lactulose is accumulated within the colon and increase the movements of the colon. And this drug is available as syrup in order to treat chronic constipation. This drug can also be indicated for portal systemic encephalopathy. So this is a hepatic encephalopathy, where accumulation of ammonia within the blood can produce encephalopathy of liver. So in such conditions, lactulose can be given, as this drug is going to increase the excretion of ammonia so that the ammonia levels within the serum can be reduced. In this way, lactulose can be used for these two conditions in the treatment of chronic constipation as well as in the management of portal systemic encephalopathy. So today in this video, we are going to see how this drug acts, how it is going to increase the movements of colon, what are the important precautions, side effects, doses, all these things we will discuss in this video. First of all, it is the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the structure of lactulose. It is a disaccharide, and here we can clearly observe this is the galactose ring, and this is nothing but fructose. So lactulose is a galactosyl fructose. Now let us see how this drug acts. Lactulose, even it is a disaccharide, it is not absorbable, it is not cleaved as monosaccharide. But within the colon, it can be converted into acidic components which reduce the pH of the colon. So at this acidic pH, lactulose can produce few of the effects on colon. One of the important effect is to increase the osmotic pressure. So because of increased osmotic pressure, it can increase the secretion of water into the colon. So fluids are retained within the colon, which further increase the movements, and soothing of fecal matter can be observed with this lactulose. This drug can also increase the development of gut flora. So the probiotic bacteria is going to be improved in presence of lactulose. This probiotic bacteria can reduce those bacteria which utilize the ammonia. So ammonia utilization is reduced within the colon. And finally, this drug can convert the ammonia into ammonium ion, which is not easily absorbed, so it is going to be excreted within the feces. In this way, ammonia is excreted out of the body as ammonium ion. This can reduce the encephalopathy in the patients with portal systemic encephalopathy. Lactulose is a non-absorbable disaccharide. This drug is going to be accumulated within the colon, where the bacteria within the colon can reduce this lactulose to acidic components such as lactic acid, acetic acid, formic acid. So these acidic components can release the protons which reduce the pH of the colon. Normally the ammonia which is present in the colon can be absorbed into the systemic circulation very rapidly. But when this ammonia is going to be ionized in low pH, it can form the ammonium ion. Since ammonium ion is having the ionic charge, it is slowly absorbed into the systemic circulation. So most of the ammonia can be converted into ammonium ion within the colon, which is not easily absorbable, so it is going to be excreted within the feces. In this way, the serum ammonia levels can be reduced by lactulose. Similarly, because of reduced pH within the colon, the acidic environment promotes the development of probiotic bacteria, and it also promotes the water secretion into the colon, which increases the movements of the colon, so that the colon movements can promote the propulsion of fecal matter. So softening of tools can take place by use of lactulose. In this way, lactulose can reduce the constipation as well as it can reduce the serum ammonium levels by converting the ammonia into ammonium ion, which is excreted within the feces. Now let us see the precautions of lactulose. This drug can be converted into two fragments, galactose and lactose. So these two monosaccharides can impact the glucose levels within the diabetic patients. So in the patients with diabetes mellitus, this lactulose should be carefully given. And we have seen that lactulose can reduce the ammonia levels within the serum. So this drug can be indicated for the management of portal systemic encephalopathy, PSE. But this requires long-term treatment. In such conditions, this lactulose can produce some electrolyte disturbances. So generally, this electrolyte disturbance is observed when this lactulose is used for greater than 6 months. In such patients, the potassium levels may fall, resulting in the hypokalemia. The sodium levels may fall, resulting in the hyponatremia, which may impact the function of cardiovascular system. That's why when this drug is indicated for greater than 6 months, the electrolyte test should be done in order to assess any development of hypokalemia and hyponatremia within the patients. What are the side effects? The important side effects mainly related with colon. It can produce some flatulence, which is one of the important side effects that can be observed with the lactulose. As the gas is going to be entrapped, it can produce the flatulence. It can also produce some intestinal cramps. At a high dose, it can retain the fluids, resulting in the diarrhea. And on long-term use, it can reduce the electrolyte levels, resulting in hypokalemia and hyponatremia. So these side effects should be carefully monitored when this lactulose is prescribed for longer periods. How it is given? This drug is available as a syrup at a strength of 10 gram per 15 ml. So each 15 ml of the syrup contains 10 grams of the lactulose. And the dose of the drug depends on the type of clinical indication. For the treatment of chronic constipation, lactulose is given at a dose of 15 to 30 ml given as once daily. The maximum dose is 60 ml per day. But for the management of PSE, portal systemic encephalopathy, this drug is given at a high dose. So 30 to 45 ml of lactulose is given for 3 to 4 times daily, such that the serum ammonia levels can be reduced. At such a high dose, this drug may produce diarrhea as well as it can impact the electrolyte levels. So care should be taken when this drug is prescribed at high dose. So that's about this drug lactulose, which is a disaccharide which can be used for the management of chronic constipation as well as it is indicated for the treatment of portal systemic encephalopathy. So that's for today. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.